There was a time I used to look into my father's eyes. In a happy home, I was a king, I had a golden throne. Those days are gone, now the memories on the wall. I hear the songs from the places where I was born. Upon a hill across the blue lake, that's where I had my first heartbreak. I still remember how it all changed. My father said, don't you worry, child. See, heaven's got a plan for you. Don't you worry now. A time I met a girl of a different kind. We ruled the world. I thought I'd never lose her out of sight. We were so young. I think of her now and then. I still hear the song.
This is Sky Sports News, your home of sports news.
Hello, I'm Mike Wedderburn on Sky Sports News. Today we're bringing you an important report from the Sky Skills studios. Let's go straight to Studio One.
Hi, I'm Jake Wright.
And I'm Nathan Chambers, and you're watching Sky Sports News. Our breaking news today, the Olympic legacy, is it succeeding or failing?
The government spent over £9 billion on the Olympics. What a huge amount of cash.
They're hoping it was an event that will encourage millions of young people to take up sport and be healthy.
But will it? Figures from 2012 show us that 20% of children in London are obese.
Obese means really overweight.
In order to help children such as these into action, the government gave away 50,000 Olympic tickets to various London schools.
It's hoped that the thousands of children who got these tickets will be inspired by the Olympics to take up a sport for themselves and use the Olympic venues to practice and play matches in.
Has this happened? Are pupils that interested in taking up sport? Has the government wasted billions of pounds?
To find out just how young sporting people are,
we're going to join Kate and Elsa in Hogwarts.
Thank you, Jake and Nathan. I'm here at Hogwarts High, where a lot of young people come to do different sports.
This is not an Olympic venue, but this is where children train and maybe one day could be representing their country in the Olympic Games.
But are children doing enough sport to get to the Olympics?
They probably don't, but the idea of coming to an Olympic venue may be the magnet some less active young people need. The latest figures on school sports reveals that at least 2 million London children don't do enough sport.
They may enjoy kicking a ball around now and then, but for sport to do you good, it has to happen regularly. That means more than once a week. A recent survey shows that young people who did sport outside school had stronger friendships, were more confident and also happier with the way they looked.
Many of the government's Olympic ideas made a big impact on young people, and the payoff for these should mean Olympic sites are filled with the athletes of the future.
To see how at least one Olympic venue is doing, we're going to join Andrew, who's at the Aquatic Centre in Stratford.
Bye from us.
Thank you, Kate and Elsa. I'm here at the Olympic swimming pools with John Smith, aka the Dolphin.
Yes, I'm John Smith. I'm a good person. Kids, stay in school.
Isn't he wonderful? He swam for Team GB during the games. So, John, looks pretty empty in here. Are kids really going to visit places like these in the thousands?
Of course they would. This is an amazing place. This is a swimming pool that famous people have swum in, and also, most importantly, I have swum in this pool right here. This is a great place for your child to come and get exercise, and they would really want to come here because I have swum in this pool.
What got you into swimming?
I wasn't always into it. In fact, I didn't exercise much at all when I was young, but I felt really bad and kept getting ill. But now I am never ill.
Don't mean to spoil your fun, but you sound a bit unhealthy.
Shh, I'm not ill. People who are always doing sport, like me obviously, don't get ill. I decided to take up a sport and found I was good at swimming. I mean, awesome, because I'm the best person in the UK. This took me all the way to the Olympics.
What an amazing story. So, are there benefits to doing all sports, or just some?
Oh, any sport is good. Doing sport can boost your self-confidence and self-esteem. But because I'm amazing, I already have great self-confidence.
Of course.
Also, sport teaches you great life skills like discipline and focus. Let's not forget, it also keeps you fit and healthy.
Which is very important, especially with obesity on the rise.
Exactly. Obesity is no joke. Fact, obesity does not help you swimming.
Great. Thanks to my guest, John Smith. We're now handing over to Bo back in the studio for some interesting opinion.
Yes, thank you, Andrew, from Studio 3. We are now live in Studio 4 with Ben and Jerry, who are economists and were part of the London 2012 committee. So, Ben, what was your view on London 2012 now that it's all finished?
I think it was an amazing, successful event. London should be proud.
It was amazingly expensive, I'll give you that.
Do you think it was good value for money, Jerry?
Not at all. The bill for just the security guards was £560 million. Also, other countries that have hosted the Games haven't made a profit. The UK committee must have known this before they spent all the money they did.
Now, Ben, did you know all this?
Yes, however, we made sure our plans for the Games meant we made money. We built 9,000 new homes in poor areas of London, all of these great venues, and even more parks.
But can people afford these new homes, and are the venues still in use?
Exactly. The new homes have pushed prices up in poorer areas, which seems to be really silly to me. Also, a lot of the venues are now lying empty.
That won't always be the case. They will be used by children and professionals, and even tourists.
I don't believe tourists will come from the other side of the world to visit an empty velodrome or swimming arena. I think the Games were a bad investment.
Well, that's all we have time here for, so I think we'll leave it there. Yes, thank you to my guests, Ben and Jerry. I'm Bo Bailey, and goodbye.
You're so extra.
Not at all.
Yes, thank you, Andrew, from Studio.
You started.
No!
You
did it again!
So, Jerry, do you think it was good value for money?
Not at all. The bill for just the security guards was £560 million.
Thanks for watching, and thank you to the Sky Skills studio team.
This is Sky Sports News, your home of sports news.